It looked scary for quite a while for the Toronto Blue Jays this afternoon against the Tigers. However, Teoscar Hernandez with a big-time three-run bomb there in the bottom half of the sixth inning gives the Jays the 5-3 win over the Tigers, and with the W, they now improve to 56-45 on the year. And we just witnessed, Jays fans, what a non-leverage pitcher looks like, and that is former Blue Jay Derek Law of the Detroit Tigers. We'll get to him very shortly, but let's talk about the ballgame. Former Blue Jay Drew Hutchison gets the start, and after the first inning, he dialed in and was great. In the bottom of the first, however, Gurriel hits an RBI single. Vladdy comes in to score after he got on base via the hit. And the Jays are up 1-0. That was all the offense the Jays got in the five innings that Drew Hutchison was on the mound. And Ross Stripling was doing good until that fifth inning where, you know, gets the bases loaded with nobody out. And then sack fly from Clemens. And then they bring in Adam Simber. And this is why you want strikeout stuff, guys. This is a reason why. Because Green hits an RBI double and Robbie Grossman scores with the guy at first and second and one out. You want to get those strikeout guys because if they miss their spot, you still have the stuff. You still have the velocity to get away with mistakes. When Adam Simber makes a mistake, it's like 88 down the middle or 88 up and it's going to get crushed. And this is a prime example as why. He gives up an RBI double and we are tied at 2. Somehow finds a way to get out of that inning. But then we go to the top of the sixth inning, and Simber's still on the mound. Jonathan Schoop hits an RBI single. Jamer Candelario comes in to score. And just like that, the Jays are losing 3-2. Or sorry, excuse me. No, they only had one run. So it was a 1-2-1 ball game after the fifth. And they're down 3-1 in the sixth inning. And I'm watching this, and I'm thinking, those big bullpen arms are right around the corner for the Tigers. So if you're the Blue Jays, you got to get your offense fast. And in that bottom of the sixth, they go to Derek Law. And you know, we all know that once you get past that sixth inning and you get to the 7, 8, and 9, you know who you're going to see. So if you're the Blue Jays, that is your inning. And it starts with an Espinal single. Then short, George Springer bounces into a double play, but hold on, they review it. He's safe at first, and we'll get to Springer in a second. So he's safe at first, great stuff. Then Vladdy gets hit on the hands, and we're all like, oh my God, no! That is not going to happen. And then at one point, the bases get loaded, right? And Bo Bichette comes up, and we're like, Gurriel hits a comebacker to Derek Law, and he knocks it down. And try and picks it up and thinks he's to go to third to get the lead runner. Can't get a grip. Flubs it. And we have the bases loaded for Bo Bichette. And he drives one to right field. Question is it deep enough? It is. Springer tags up, flies home, and dives headfirst. He's safe at the plate. Meanwhile, he can barely get up. And it's a 3-2 ball game. But there's two out now, and it's like, now you need to get a hit. And Teoscar Hernandez comes up, and he was getting a steady dose of sliders from Derek Law. And he gets a hanger. And he drills it to dead center field, and you can tell from the reaction to Teo, he knew he got all of that one. And it's a three-run bomb for Teoscar Hernandez, putting the Jays in front now, 5-3. Big-time drive, booming drive for Teo. And the Jays have retaken the lead. It's now a 5-3 contest. Big-time drive for Teo. The team really needed it because they were getting squat on offense for the majority of this ballgame. And they still ended up with only 4 flipping hits and more runs than they did hits. They had the same amount of walks as they did hits today. Back-to-back games of 4-hit ball, that just can't happen. It just can't happen. Right? Bullpen does their job. Trevor Richards went out there to get one batter. He did. He ended up allowing a base runner. I think it was Victor Reyes, but he was a bloop single. They bring in Jimmy Garcia, and we talked about it in game one of the series, how he wasn't so sharp. Defense wasn't great behind him. Still, bases loaded, nobody out. Found a way to only allow one run against him in that opener. And then today, he just dialed in. And it was incredible for the rest of that seventh inning and remarkable for the eighth inning. And the Romano locks it down. And you win 5-3 over the Tigers, as you are supposed to. Let's get to these player stats. You know what? No, forget that, right? Actually, no, yeah, but let's get to that. Vladdy went 1-for-2 in the ballgame, scored a couple runs, walked once, and obviously got hit by a pitch. So good for him that he got on base 4 of the 5 times that he came to the dish, but. Or 4 of the 5 times? Yeah, 4 of the 5 times he came to the plate, but hope to God that hand is okay. He seemed all right. He shook it off. He played the rest of the game, so we'll see. Timo, did Kevin Biggio come in and play first? He might have. I don't know. Anyways, 4 hits total for the Blue Jays. They only had 5 strikeouts, and then they walked 4 times. You didn't get many base runners today. You found a way to win a 5-3 ball game today. Great. You'll take it and move on. Ross Stripling got the start. And he went 4 1/3, allowed 5 hits, a couple runs, 5 strikeouts, and didn't walk a batter. He was, like I said, he was great until that 5th inning where the wheels kind of fell off and he allowed a couple base runners. Then he hit a batter. And it's just, I mean, you can debate the Jonathan Scope stuff all you want to load the bases, but no matter what, he struggled in that 5th. Adam Zimmer goes an inning and a 3rd and allows 3 hits. A run, a strikeout, and he walks a batter. So he faces, hold on, let me do some math here. He goes an inning and a 3rd. So that's 4 outs. He allows 4 base runners. That's 8. Eight guys he faces, he allows 4 base runners. That's not good enough. It just isn't. He definitely wasn't sharp today. And then Trevor Richards goes out there and bails Simber out there. Because look, in the 3-1 ball game, they had runners in the corners with 2 out. They could have really built this lead up a little bit. Alas, Trevor Richards goes 2/3 an inning, allows 1 hit. It was a bloop single, gets a strikeout. And then Jimmy Garcia comes on and goes an inning and 2/3, walks 1 guy, but it was with 2 out in the 8th inning, gets a couple strikeouts, no runs. An incredible job from Jimmy. And Jordan Romano allowed some hard-hit contact a little bit, but hey, clean inning, picks up the save. Inning, 1 hit allowed, and got a strikeout, and picks up the save, a big-time save for the Blue Jays, because they needed this. Look, any game against these bad teams, when they're not clicking, they need it. Especially with the Rays winning today, and you obviously know the Yankees are going to win, and the Red Sox are trailing right now, but you can't bank on that. And with Seattle continuing to add, right? You look at the Rays, they added David Peralta. You look at the Mariners, they added Luis Castillo. Meanwhile, the Jays are sitting here like the Yankees added Benintendi. Jays are just sitting here like this right now. So, there's only a few days left until the trade deadline. And look, we all know the bullpen pieces that Jays fans want. There are so many names. Question is, will they make that move? And that's what we're going to wait and see. All right, Jays fans? But George Springer, last thing before I wrap this up and preview tomorrow. Give this guy a damn IL stint. I understand people who say, well, we need George Springer. I would love to have a healthy George Springer. And watching him like we did last year, where he was barely able to move while he was trying to play. Watching him try to play right now is just hard to watch. And it reminds me so much of last season. And then he was out for months after that. So for God's sakes, he needs an IL stint. Watching him slide into home and watching him lie down flat in his face because he's in so much pain and using his knuckles to push him up because he can't get under, can't get his elbow, he's not getting enough juice on the elbow. Like, he's not feeling good. He should not be out there. I don't care. Well, DH, when a guy's in pain the way he is, I do not want him out there. I'm sorry. I'd much rather a healthy George Springer. And if that means him being off 10, 15 days, so be it. This Jays team should be good enough to win without him there. At least for the time being. But it's really tough to watch right now. And watching him do his things like that, it's just making me pull my hair. It reminds me so much of last year. For God's sakes, give him some time off. Give him an IL stint. Give him at least 10 days. Figure it out after that. That's my thought. You guys can go nuts in the comments. The finale. No. Yes, yes. The finale of this 4-game set against the Tigers, the rubber match, somewhat, of the series, goes tomorrow afternoon. It's a 12:05 first pitch, a noon start for the Blue Jays at Rogers Center as they look to win the series 3-1. Like, you do that, it's kind of a different story, right? Like we did against the Kansas City Royals, right? You lost the first game, we're like, wow, ridiculous. Then you won 3 straight, we're like, okay, you know what, we'll take 3 of 4. You win tomorrow, you win 3 of 4, you're feeling better about yourself. All right, you lose that game, you split against the Tigers at home, not going to cut it. Garrett Hill gets the ball for the Tigers in the finale. Jose Berrios gets the hill for the Jays. He was in his last inning. I was at the ballpark for that one. He was okay, not great, but he was good enough that the Blue Jays found a way to win that ball game. And it's, like I said, 12:05 first pitch at Rogers Center. Shout out to all the fans, Jam Stadium today. Let's keep that moving. Let's keep the fan hype coming, because we're getting into August, and that's that time where we start stressing out a ton, and I'm already stressed out, but it is what it is, all right? So, Jays fans, you know what that is. We're going to do it for this one. If you enjoyed the video, and you are stressed out about today's game, but you enjoy the result, smack that like button. Do appreciate it. Hit that subscribe button. If you guys not already, comment down below. Thoughts on the video, thoughts on the game, would you like, would you not like? From today's game for the Toronto Blue Jays, the Twitter link is down below, so follow up, send me a DM to that great stuff. The Instagram link is also down below, so follow up there if you guys have not done so already. And I will talk to you guys, Jays Nation, of course, tomorrow afternoon, Jays, Tigers, the finale of the four-game set at Rogers Center. Garrett Hill, Jose Berrios is the pitching matchup, 12:05 first pitch, all right? So thank you guys so much for listening and watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and the game today. We'll talk to you guys then.